Hello everyone, I am back again to today a new project that something we can do with recycled materials like glass bottles. Or remember one thing, we are doing using glass. In case if you cannot find glass bottle, you can always go for a plastic bottle, no problem. Because if you use in plastic bottle, don't use glass paint, use acrylic paint. It will be a good idea. Of course you can use on glass paint also in plastic bottles. So this will be the project that we are doing. We are doing a nice beautiful glass jar, if you can see. So see, it's very easy. For a start, we will try with this one. Then I will tell you how to use normal flowers on the same technique but different patterns. So we are going to start like that way. First you need a glass jar and glass paint. Whatever the paint you're using, it should be nice and little bit thicker. So I'm using today a Fabio brand, and you can use your own brand, it's up to you. What I have here, purple color, use a little bit purple. So it's too dark, so I'm going to mix it together and use it. It's totally fine to actually glass paint to mix together. So we are only using a sponge to do the painting on the bottle. So the full bottle should be sponge. So I'm going to keep this one in a side, so I don't want you to be this track. So this is the bottle we will be doing. You can use use a small brush, mix the paint together. It's fine. So you will use the sponge like this way, up and down. Full bottle should be sponge like this way. So remember one thing, in case if you don't want to do anything in the top part, like for me I want all the full bottle to be colored. That's the reason. If you don't want the full bottle to be colored, make sure you put a masking tape here so the paint will not come over here. So it's fine. I'm using Fabio. You can use Marabu also. Marabu is one of the good brands. So because I want it to be quick drying, I'm going with the Fabio. Sponging technique is the easy way for you to color instead of using a brush. So half of the bottle my almost done. So I'm going to do the full bottle like this way, see. Now my full bottle is done. It should be look like something like this way, you can see. It's purple and little bit white mixing together because my purple is kind of dark. So I want it to be a little bit lighter. That's the reason I'm using two colors together. See, full bottle up and down. So remember one thing, when you do glass paint, it's very important your glass jar is very nice clean. So the technique is to clean the glass bottle is use soap and water. Once you finish it, you don't touch from the middle. So full bottle, once you clean it, you don't touch it. You use a wet wipe or something dry fabric, clean it very well. Make sure it's get 100% dry. Once it get dry, you don't touch it from here. You only hold it like this because sometimes we have moisturizer in our hand. It can go to here and when you put the glass paint, it will be not sticking. So next thing, like this bottle is already done and but it's already dry also. I did it yesterday and kept. So normally when you do the background on a bottle, make sure you leave it for like 20 minutes in a side to dry. Don't try it right away. So I'm going to make a first flower. I'm going to color with, I'm using a point brush and I will be doing like a circle. I'm going to do is brush points like this way. If you look at it, short lines but like a circle. I'm using a little bit darker pink color. I do not use lot of paint. When you take paint to the brush, make sure you remove the extra paint. If not, it will start to like drip all the way. Like this way, dripping can happen. So when you're doing it, like you write in letter C, backwards or frontwards, like this way, you just go circle. So one color is done, because I want to use like few colors. I will play around with another two colors. Wipe your brush, and I'm using a wet wipe to clean, because if I use a lot of water, it will be hard. But even with the wet wipe, I'm cleaning very well the brush. I don't leave the paint with the brush. I'm going to use a different color, but in the places that don't have paint. Still, your hand should be go like a circle. Once you do the sponging, you can try with brushing also. Instead of sponging, you can brush the full bottle, but it takes time. At least you need to do 2 to 3 layers to get that thickness. So, I will try another color now. We'll try a little bit yellow. You can play around with the colors. That is very important, because you have to enjoy the coloring. So I'm highlighting with little bit yellow. This paint is kind of quick drying, so you don't have a lot of dripping part will happening. So I think that's enough for a hard colors, but now I will add little bit white, so it will be look nice. My bottle is not total white color. I add little bit pink color to the white. Mix it well and then use it. So now when you use the white color, you can go over. You can see it look like this way, circle way. Please, if you have any question, you can ask from me. Your hand should be go like a circle way, very important. So if you see now, these flowers I already done with few colors together. It's very nice. Now I'm going to use is the leaves. I'm going to do green color, and I need to make sure that my brush is very well clean. I don't use water at the moment, because water will be hard for me to clean the brush always. That's the reason. I'm going to use is, oops. So remember one thing, first make the outliner the way you like. Inside the outliner you will start to color with different colors. Finish up with one color, like don't totally color the leaf, like this way leave it. some places with no color. Even with the leaves, I'm going to use two different greens. If you don't have two different greens, you can always highlight with white color, not the green color also. So it should be look like now this way. Normally, in case if you don't, you want to go a little bit over the flower, the green color, it's totally fine because little bit over the flower will be looking nice. So if you see, now my leaves are like look like this way. It's very easy, not though so hard. So I will wait for it to few seconds. I will clean my brush and I'm going to use a different, like I have a different green. I'm going to play with that green also. Go over, it's total fine. Okay. I'm going to use white color, that will be much more look nice. White color or yellow color also good. So it will look like this way now. Don't put too much white color, it will be not, it will become totally white. So you just use little bit white color to highlight only. This should be look like this way now. So we colored the background with the sponge, then we start with the flowers and then we, so it's very important your brush strokes should be nice, that's it. You don't take too much pressure. Okay. I have now different green, I'm going to use that green also to just to give a nice effect. And remember, it should not perfect, just lines you will do. If you like, you can add a little bit yellow also to the green. Okay, now I told you that I will tell you how to do something like this way, very small flowers and these lines, how can you decorate it like that. So I'm going to do is, you can use a different brush or same brush, it's up to you. I'm going to do the same technique in the same bottle. I will use a different color like blue color. So some of the colors you have to shake it, it's very important. You just dip it and stamp like this way. So like that way. So once it gets dry only you can do a inside part. Not before it get dry. just the point of the brush. That's very important. Not the full brush, just the point of the brush you will be using. So, like that way. It's very important you play around with the colors. So when you come to the lines, you can just use a much more smaller brush for the point, not too big one. Use the point brush and just do the lines the way you like. If you guys don't know to draw the paint, it's very important you can do the background, use a pencil and draw it. So don't put pressure onto the pencil, then the paint will peel and come. So when you're doing it, in case if you don't know to draw by yourself, the tracing will be much more good. So you can always use pencil for the tracing without putting too much pressure to the brush. So your bottle will, if not, the peel will, paint will be peeling and coming when you're doing it. So this will be today's lesson. It's very easy, not too hard for you, and we can put little bit white color in the middle for the flowers. So, I hope you guys will be enjoying today's lesson too. We did was glass painting. Use an old glass jar, clean it very well. Once you clean it, don't touch it from the middle. And once you've done it, you make sure you use the sponge and do the painting. You will go up and down, sponging. Use something for light for the background. Like here, I want to do a snowman, but what did I do? I use a light blue to the background. If you use a dark color, you can, it will be hard for you to do. So, use a light color. If you use a dark color, use like this way. See, this background is dark pink. I use little bit purple color I add and mix together and use it. So then I use darker flowers. That's why. So when you use a darker background, go for lighter color for the flowers and things. So I use pink color in this and did the flowers, you can see. I hope you guys enjoyed today's lesson. See you tomorrow with a new project. Thank you for watching me.